develop.
Okay. Now, I know you're big into marketing. Did you market or major in marketing at Georgetown?
I did.
Okay. Does it help that Jamil's a local kid as far as your marketing effort? Have you sold that when you've gone out and spoken to groups at all?
No question. It's exciting to have some local guys in the program. We've got two from Delta, and of course Jamil from right here in Muncie. And tomorrow, as a matter of fact, Jamil will be heavily involved
with
some of our downtown Paint the Town Red efforts. Our whole team will be there, but Jamil has got to be one of those guys. And when he got up and spoke to our team the other night, you can just tell that he takes so much pride in being from this town and being able to represent this town. Basically, our guys will get into their jerseys, they'll take posters, they'll take schedule cards, and they'll get out into all the local businesses and basically like they're running for office. They're going to go into those places and introduce themselves and shake hands and let these people know that we want to see them in the stands for Eastern Michigan on August 30th and for the other four home games as well. And then later on, we'll do the same thing down at the South Side at one of the visitors' bureaus. And then we plan to take the whole team on Tuesday night down to the Colts practice in Anderson.
And, are you really?
And it's the last night practice that the Colts will have before they start their preseason games. Hopefully there's going to be several thousand people there, and it'll be a great opportunity for our team to get some visibility there as
well. So just to mingle with the crowd, or are the Colts going to have you out on the sidelines or something? Or what's going on?
Well, it's certainly going to be a neat experience for our guys to be able to see them practice as well. Yeah. But we're hoping that there's some additional visibility generated by being over there.
Just football fans in East Central Indiana, and you want to get out and get your message across to them?
No question. And I'm guessing that there's going to be a lot of people up from Indianapolis watching.
Are you doing more marketing of Ball State football than you did at Lehigh or Elon?
It's probably comparable.
Is it? Oh, okay.
But to me, I don't really think of it as marketing. I just think of it as the right way to do things. We want to be a very, very visible part of this university, and we want to reach out and touch as many people as we can and make them feel like they're a part of what's going on. And if we do that, I think the residual of it is you see more people in the stands on Saturdays.
Well, how do you balance being a football coach and getting all that done and then also being a salesman and devoting some time to that?
Well, you've got to have a great staff that you trust, and you got to be willing to delegate to those guys. And I'm really fortunate that we have an awesome staff led by two coordinators that have been with me 8 and 7 years. So day to day, if I'm involved in some macro issues and some external issues as the head coach, I know that things are getting done the way they're supposed to be from a schematic standpoint.